So I'm gonna take you through my bracket journey. I guess this is something that's kind of popular on the YouTube tennis forums now. But yeah, I mean, I guess first of all, changing and switching rackets really doesn't help your tennis. I think the best way to help your tennis is to actually play, record yourself play, and get a coach and all that good stuff. But I do believe that in playing and testing different rackets, you sort of learn different things about your game, what your current game style is, and things change. I know that 10 years ago, I played a much different way than I do play now. So it's good to know like who you are as a person and who you think you are, what the video shows you are, and what your opponents think you are. I think those are sometimes could be three different players. But anyhow, I'm gonna dive right through it. For me, I'm an all-court player, right? I like to mix things up. I could serve and volley when needed, but not necessarily exclusively. I could play aggressive from the baseline. I could play defensive from the baseline. I really like to adjust to what I see my opponent's strengths and weaknesses are and play to those. So, and I'm gonna go through stroke by stroke. So backhand for me is sort of my stable shot and one that, especially since I switched for a few years back from one-hander to two-hander, I felt like I could be pretty consistent with the two-hander, and really now I'm working on developing that power and the put-away power. So backhand has been reliable. So with my backhand, I've had problems in terms of not getting that racket drop that we often see that the pros do. So really not getting that full topspin, right? So that's why I liked some like the aerodynamic racket. So the Head Extreme Tour and previously the Pure Aero VS, and that I could sort of just use my wrist and get easy spin from it. And the shape of the head, like it just cuts through the air very quickly. So that's why I like it. But one thing that I found actually when looking at the video is with rackets that are, I'm gonna use Wilson rackets. With Wilson rackets that are more of, I don't know what they call it, maybe straight beam, solid beam, like where it feels like a log, right? My form actually kind of looks better because like you can't just, I'm gonna bring the Wilson racket out right now. So I'll bring my ProStep 90. You can't just whip with your hands because you're gonna get a bad shot or you're gonna frame it because of the racket. It's not really aerodynamic per se. So you have to actually bend your knees and then drop the racket head. And once you do all that, you get a really clean shot. So that's what I've been finding. I think that's why I really gelled with the Diadem Elevate. I'm gonna bring that out right now. Because it was like, so the 85 was back in the day, right? The ProStep 85. I think I appreciate a little bit more forgiveness, right? So the Diadem Elevate, this is the latest one. I like it because it's lighter weight than the ProStep. Plus it still gives you that same like solid feel where you really have to use the appropriate technique and then you hit a clean backhand, right? So that's with a backhand. Forehand, my forehand has just been off. I mean, it's like, it's a roller coaster with my forehand. And because it's always been a roller coaster, I think that's why I liked the 85 back in the day, because it was relatively low powered. I could swing out and like even miss hits, which happen often, would go in because the racket was just low power and it's kind of point and shoot with this sort of racket. Plus like it was so heavy that it was heavy static weight and low in terms of the swing weight. So for some reason that helped with my timing for the forehand. But in general, I found that I could hit forehands with heavy swing weights, but it would need to be balanced appropriately in the handle, right? I don't necessarily like to do all the weight at the top and nothing in the base. All right, so let's go back to the elevate, right? So elevate both the V2 right here, and the turquoise and the V3. Both are great rackets. I've used both, I can use both. To me, the issue with both of them had been, actually it's not an issue with the racket, it's just an issue with me. And I'm looking for the racket to mask my flaws, is that these both have open square patterns, right? And if I get a little bit launchy on the forehand, so if I'm lifting up too quickly, right, then the ball is just gonna sail. And because of, number one, because of my bad technique, and then number two, the racket is powerful enough and open enough where the incorrect angle on your shot with your forehand would cause it to sail. I think it was mitigated a bit in the version 3, probably the Cravon technology and making the version 3 a bit softer helped to rein in some of the control issues that I had. But yeah, so what I'm figuring out about my game, about my racket choice, is that I do like a tighter string pattern, right? So even in my, I feel like I'm going all over the place here, but bear with me. We're gonna get to the final soon. All right, so even with the extreme tour, it's a 16 by 19, but I feel like the pattern is tighter than the 16 by 20, right? So I like this tight pattern here, but like, I don't necessarily, I think I prefer the Wilson-like rackets, or the Pro Staff or Dynams for the backhand. And with this, the extreme tour on the forehand, it's hit or miss. Actually, it's hit or miss with all the rackets. But with this one, I definitely have to focus on topspin, right? Focus on hit or topspin, especially with the setup I have with the weight of 12. Just really brushing up on the ball. And if I'm confident, and if I'm not nervous, I get so nervous during matches. I don't know why I still got nervous. I'm able to play well, really well with the extreme tour, right? So it's always been in my bag, and it's one where like if I'm going off for a relaxed hit, and I just really like using a racket because it feels good when you strike the ball cleanly. So now I'm taking a circuitous tour, and now we're gonna go to the racket that I've been using most recently. So this is a Wilson Blade version 7. So I like this because it has it's light in stock weight, so it's 305 grams. It has the sort of stability, whatever Wilson does, that maybe they put a bunch of weight here to make it feel really stable. So it has the same stability as the Pro Staffs, etc. It feels, again, the same thing on the back end where like I can't necessarily just whip, right? Because it'll just give you a bad shot. So I've actually been hitting really clean with this because I had to use the kinetic chain, right? This is an 18 by 20. And I put in 4G here. So it's relatively lowish. I wouldn't call this low powered, because like when you strike the ball cleanly on this, the ball just like it penetrates. I feel like it's picking up speed as you're going along. But you do have to take cuts. Like you can't necessarily just push the ball, right? So this one rewards you for taking cuts of the ball. And the forehand, like I get some good topspin when I time it correctly and I'm taking a big swing on it, right? The issue that I've had with the version 7, and it's it's a little bit of an issue. It's just that I don't have any weight here at the head. I bought this used. Maybe the person person I got it from like snuck some weight in the head, but I don't think that there's any weight. I put some weight in the handle to counterbalance, so the balance is perfect for me. I mentioned this in a previous video. I had two screws going on right here. But I measured the swing weight of this, and without any apparent weight in the head, and as I measured manually at 348, which is ridiculous. Like that's a whole, like 348 swing weight in a 305 gram racket. That's like, I feel like somebody just put a lot of pre-preg material in the head and just kind of forgot how much they put in. But it's, yeah, I mean, it's massive. So like, again, this is super stable. I'm able to sort of block back anything. And like in terms of volleys and everything, backhand is super stable. Forehand, when I'm timing it correctly, it's really good. But I actually feel like maybe a little bit too much in terms of the swing weight. I feel like that if I had a little bit more play with my forehand, so if I could generate a little bit more head speed a little easier, then I could probably do more consistent, heavier topspin shots rather than my sort of sporadic consistency with the forehand. So one thing I want to try now, so I think we're reaching an end, and thank you for going on this long journey with me. So one thing I want to retry now is a version 8 Wilson Blade 18x20. I feel like when I reviewed that, I felt that it was underpowered in terms of the backhand, but I think in stock form, it's listed at 325 in terms of swing weight. So add in maybe like 3 grams on top for the version 8, the blade. I should be able to get the swing weight up to like 335, which is reasonable, right? And maybe counterbalance that in the handle to get to keep the same balance that I like. And look into towards testing that. And that's what I found from my racket journey in terms of my preferences. So something that has that Pro Staff like feel, a tight string pattern, and probably like a 330-ish, maybe a little bit higher swing weight. The higher swing weight I prefer for the backhand, and then like medium-ish swing weight for the forehand. So racket set I think would be a good fit, potentially the Wilson Blade version 8. Right, Dunlop CX Tour, I think 200 or something, the 95 square inch one, the 1820 version. I'll probably have to mod that up. The Solinco Whiteout 1820, regular, not the extended, and then probably we need to add some weight in the handle and maybe a little bit at the tip. Yeah, those are three. And the Wilson Shift, I mean, I really enjoyed when I played with that racket. You felt like, at least I played the 16 and 19, I felt like the ball was going to sail, but it's kind of just stayed in. But I don't know. I don't think I can do that on a regular basis. So I'm going to do a quick play test, probably comparing the Blade version 7 to the version 8. And then see if I can find a nice groove with the version 8. But that's where I'm at, and I'm enjoying the whole process, enjoying the tennis. So hopefully you can enjoy your own racket journey as well. All right, this is Andy from Tennis with Andy. Play smart and see results.